Everyone feel for your pulse. Hold out your hand, thumb up, and feel for the knobby bone at the top of your wrist. Okay, now slide your hand down across the front of your wrist. Feel those like strands of spaghetti. Those are the tendons in your wrist. If you press lightly between that knobby bone and that first tendon, you should feel your pulse. Got it? Okay, now what we're going to do is feel what happens to our pulse when we take a deep breath. We're going to try it twice. Try to feel what happens to your pulse when you inhale and when you exhale. All right, here we go. Slow inhale. Slow exhale. One more time. In. Out. What happened when you breathed in and breathed out? You should have felt your pulse speed up when you inhaled and slow down when you exhaled. That's called heart rate variability, a measure of the control our vagus nerve has over our heart. And it's a good thing. A healthy heart is not a metronome. Low heart rate variability predicts greater risk of heart disease and death from several causes. High-risk patients with low variability in heart rate have twice the risk of dying prematurely. Is there anything we can do to positively impact heart rate variability? Voluntary slow breathing at about 6 breaths per minute is a technique that's been used for thousands of years. It's an essential part of many meditative and relaxation practices. It can benefit several heart rate variability parameters, offering a low-tech, low-cost technique. Speaking of low-tech, low-cost, what about exercise? Aerobic training at least twice a week positively influences heart nerve control. What about what we eat? Those eating plant-based diets have better overall heart rate variability. Vegetarians, for example, don't tend to have only better blood pressures, cholesterol, triglycerides, and blood sugars. They also have better heart rate variability. The vagus nerve toning effects of plant-based diets may help explain part of their cardioprotective effect. Any plants in particular? While no significant association was seen between heart rate variability measures and the intake of fruits and vegetables in general, the consumption of green leafy vegetables seems to stand out, perhaps helping to explain why eating just a half serving of greens a day may cut a risk of having a heart attack by up to 67%.